problem.
Am I audible?
Yes, Sipshita, you're audible.
Have you started, Sita?
Good morning to everyone present here. So we have a guest today with us. That is Neha Sharma ma'am. So she is going to deliver her insights on the topic success through goal setting. So before she starts and she takes off the topic, I would like to introduce Neha ma'am. So Mrs. Neha Sharma is an assistant professor at the Institute of Information Technology affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indoprastha University, Delhi. Her prior assignment was with HDFC Bank as an assistant manager in Hyderabad. She is pursuing a PhD from Punjab Technical University, Jalandhar in the area of human resource management, psychological contract, organizational citizenship behavior, and employee turnover intention. The profile includes teaching variety of subjects like strategic and international HRM, compensation management, human resource management, business communication. Yeah, am I audible? Hello?
If their voice is lagging.
Breaking, my voice is breaking. Yeah. Can I just do one thing? Can I log in once? I'm also facing some network issues.
Can you hear me?
Yes, you are audible.
Can we start directly with Neha ma'am?
Yes, no problem.
I'm really sorry, Neha, for this technical error.
No, not an issue.
Sita, you can do this introduction part on a later stage.
Yeah, not an issue. So, can I start with the goal setting?
Yes. Most welcome.
Yeah. So today the topic mutually decided by me and Captain Shekhar, it is success through goal setting for all of you. I hope I'll be adding some value to you people towards the end of the session. So before exactly going into the depth of goal setting, let me just tell you in brief that I'm assistant professor and I'm in this teaching profession since 2008. And I'm interacting with a lot of students around me. In fact, a lot of teachers and a lot of people around me every now and then. And I have actually realized that all of us, including students and even we, all of us, we are so ready with our plans every day and night. We are ready with what sort of web series we are going to watch this weekend, what special dinner we are going to prepare this weekend. We are also very sure about the holiday trips, and we plan about our holiday trips, whether national or international, 6 months or 1 year prior. We are ready with our international trips and national trips and where we want to go and how we'll plan and go about it. So we are ready with all these things in our day-to-day life. But when I ask anyone, whether a student or any person around, and I ask them, what are your life goals? What exactly is the purpose of your life? Is the purpose of your career? What do you want to do in your life? And they look at me as if I've asked a weird question to them. So just wanted to say that the crux of it, that in our entire life, we want the best out of our life. We want money. We want successful career. We want everything best out of our life, but without any goals. We don't have any set goals in our life. So just ask this question to yourself, that how many goals did you set in the last 6 months or 1 year, and how many of them have you actually achieved? Now, let me tell you, the researchers have actually proved that only 10% people in this entire world, they set goals in their life. And out of those 10%, only 2 to 3% people are able to achieve their goals successfully in their life. So today I'm here to let you know the secret behind those 2 to 3% people, those who actually are able to achieve their goals in their life. So first of all, let's clarify the difference between a dream and a goal. There is a difference between a dream and a goal. Let me give you an example to state or highlight the difference in a more clear way. So just imagine that I have a dream of buying a Mercedes-Benz car, the latest model, that is S-Class, having more than 3900 cc. Okay, so that's my dream. I want this car in my life. So that is only a dream. But now listen carefully. I want Mercedes-Benz latest S-Class model car in 1 year of time span. Let me work out how much it cost, or let me work out whether I'll be able to buy this car in cash, or do I need to take loan from a bank? If loan, then which bank? What is the rate of interest, and how much amount of money do I need to save throughout this 1 year so that I can buy Mercedes-Benz, my dream car? Now this becomes your goal, because you are working on it, the actions are there, and you are setting plans, so you are working out that how I'm going to achieve this. Now this becomes a goal. Otherwise, everything, whatever you are thinking in your life, is only a dream. So exact difference between a dream and a goal is, the dreams are only wishful thinking in your life, and goals are actually the actions which you take. They are the real roadmap that will actually take you towards the achievement of your dreams. So the real difference between the goal and a dream is taking an action. Goal setting is only, it's just like shooting an arrow, and you cannot shoot an arrow without a pre-decided target. So you need to have target in your life, then only you can shoot an arrow and you are going to accomplish something in your life. Now, if you are still not satisfied that, yes, really, do we need goals in our life? So let me tell you, just imagine a situation, or do you ever have board a train without any destination? Have you ever board a train without any destination, without any destination in your mind? Just imagine a situation, you are going to a railway station and you are asking a ticket counter to give you a ticket, I need a ticket. Or definitely that person will ask you, kaha ki ticket chahiye? Where do you want to go? And what you will be saying, just imagine, I don't know where I want to go, but I want to go somewhere. Give me a ticket. Wouldn't you be sounding so weird? This is just next to impossible, isn't it? You are boarding a train without any destination. Let me give you one another example. You have planned a holiday from New Delhi to Jammu and Kashmir. It is the distance is approximately 605 kilometer. And everything is so specific for you. From New Delhi railway station to Jammu, you'll be boarding a train from New Delhi railway station. The time of the train is so specific. You know the departure time. You know the train number. You know the seat number. You know the platform number. You are also aware of the hotel bookings of 4 to 5 days, which hotel, which room, where you have to land up. You know everything. Now, just ask this question to yourself. Everything is so specific for the 605 kilometer journey. But what about your life? What about your life? You've already spent more than 20 years of your life without any goals in your mind, without knowing anything, without any purpose in your life that what exactly you want to do. Now, this is for those people who doesn't have any goals in their life. So no specification, no goals, no directions since last 20 years. You don't have any goals in your mind. So I think now I have made myself so clear that how goal setting is so important in everyone's life. It is very well said by J.C. Penney, give me a stock clerk with a goal and I'll give you a man who will make a history. And give me a man with no goals, irrespective of whatever position he or she is, I'll give you a stock clerk back. So irrespective of how much hardworking you are, how much talented you are, but if you don't have any set goals in your life, you'll be unable to achieve anything in your life. You'll just remain a stock clerk. The other person defining your life, the other person, maybe your employer or maybe your family member, guiding you what to do and what not to do. And you'll be 100% dedicated to the achievement of the goals of the organization or the goals of other people in your life rather than your own goals. So by this, I think I have made myself so clear that why goal setting is so important in anyone's life. Now let's come to how goals need to be. Goals kaise hone chahiye? Goals need to be SMART. The SMART acronym is like S stands for specific. It needs to be very much specific, like you want to reduce weight and you just set your goals that, yes, I'll be reducing my weight around 2 kg this month and I'll be doing regular exercises. Now, this is not that specific. 2 kg is specific, but I'll do regular exercises. That is not that specific. The roadmap needs to be very specific. I'll be working out 30 minutes regularly in the morning from 6 to 6:30. So that is, you are coming out with more specifications in your goal and your roadmap. So your goals need to be very much specific. Measurable. Yes, they need to be measurable. You need to measure. If you have decided to lose 2 kg or maybe 3 kg in a month, you need to measure it. It is measurable, and the moment after every 10 days or 1 week, you will keep on measuring it. That will give you more and more motivation to move ahead on that path, because you'll be seeing that, yes, you are able to achieve certain things. They should be achievable. Achievable means they should be actually be as per your skills and talent which you have. And if you don't have that skill and talent to achieve the goals or dream that you have in your life, you need to adopt and you need to get that talent. You need to learn that skill to achieve that goal. So that should be achievable, and it is possible to some extent. Realistic. Yes, it needs to be realistic. It should not be like just a wishful dream and just a fairy tale or something. It has to be real in your life. And your mind should accept it that, yes, this is true and this is real. It can happen. So it has to go in that way. Timely, yes, it has to be time bound. The example I gave of Mercedes Benz, I said that yes, I want that car in another 1 year. So that is very much specific, time bound. The goals need to be time bound, and you can split your goals into different small parts, different actions that you're going to achieve, and every action should be time bound. Every action should be very much smart, like your goals are. So goals need to be very smart in your life. Now, there are certain myths about goal setting. The very first myth is, I already have goals. Now, many people, they actually, if I ask them, what are your goals? Most of the time, you'll get the answer, yes, I have goals. I want to be rich. I want to be successful in my career. I want to study abroad. I want to join TCS or any good company. So I would say, crazy people, these are not goals. These are only wishes common to every mankind. Every person wants to be rich. Every person wants to be successful in their career. These are only merely an illusions. Goals are carefully designed. They are upgraded every now and then continuously. And a proper roadmap has to be formed. Proper workout has to be there on that particular goal. How you're going to achieve and by what time you will be achieving it. And you have to work upon that day and night. So if you say, I already have goals, just give a thought to it. What are your goals? Second important myth is, I don't need goals. I am already doing fine. Now, this is another myth. Let me tell you, living your life without any goal is a ship without a radar, which will go nowhere. It is like an envelope without any address, and definitely it will go nowhere. So without goal, you'll not be able to go anywhere. And if you still think that I'm already doing fine without any written goals in my life, without any set plans in my life, then I would say, wow. I mean, this means that you would be probably doing extremely well if you have goals in your life. Just give a thought to it. Another important myth, I don't need written goals. I have everything in my mind. Now, this is another myth. Now, let me tell you, the average words that come in your mind per minute is around 1500. The average words that come to your mind is around 1500 words per minute. Now, if your goals are only in your mind, it has not been written or penned down anywhere, then it will get jumbled up into those 1500 words and it would be very vague and confused and it would not be clarified and inefficient in many ways. You will not be able to get clear direction of what exactly you want in your life. So without any doubt, the goals has to be in a written form, and that too, not only goals, the path and the direction which you exactly you are looking for to achieve it has to be in the written form. Another, the last myth I'll be talking about the goal setting is, goals does not work as planned. The life is so unpredictable, as we all agree to this, life is so unpredictable. So whenever I'll plan a goal, it's not necessary that I'm going to achieve it, or maybe in the coming days I have to revise it. So why to make goals in my life if the life is so unpredictable? Let me take your own example. It is like when a plane takes off to a distant city, 99% of the time it is on the set, well-defined, pre-planned course of action. But in case of any complexities, in case of any contingency, if it happens, it depends on the skills of the pilot, how he deals with the situation and takes the plane smoothly to the destination. So the same thing happened in our life also. When we set our clear-cut goals, well-defined path, but due to certain contingency or due to certain emergency, we are not able to achieve our goals. If the path has been deviated a little bit on moving towards the goal and we are facing certain problems, I would say the path can be changed a little bit, okay, to achieve your goal. But you should not lose focus from your goals, from your destination, the final destination. We have to land over there. So these are some of the myths about goal setting. And I think now I've made myself very clear how, why goals are so important in everyone's life, how the goals needs to be, and how these myths are going to be handled. And these are only myths, let me tell you. Your goals need to be there in your life. It has to be in the written form, and as well as you need to have the proper set directions to achieve your goals in the written form. Now, being a NLP practitioner, let me brief you about how goals are achieved, how we are able to achieve our goals in our life. Because everyone will say that, yes, goals are important. Everyone is going to say how the goals need to be, but no one will tell you how I'm going to achieve my goals. Is it really possible? So let me tell you a basic human mind model. It is basically, you all must be aware about the conscious and subconscious mind. The conscious mind comprises of only 10% of your brain, only 10%. And rest of the part, the 90%, you can call it as subconscious or unconscious mind. Now, conscious mind is very, very small, and it only works on the things which they receive, the what they exactly perceive. What you exactly perceive, it is based on what information you are getting through your five senses. And this is the actual functioning of the conscious mind. It do analytical thinking. It applies logic to whatever is being information that you are getting through your five senses, and then take the judgment. So that's a very small part of your brain that is conscious mind. The bigger part of your brain, that is subconscious mind, it is also known as the habit mind or a storehouse of your brain. And it has unlimited storage to store your memory. And whatever is stored in the subconscious mind, your body exactly acts according to it. Conscious mind is like you are consciously making your body to act that way. But if the things are directly going to the subconscious mind, you need not to work so well. You need not to put a lot of efforts. Everything will go very smoothly. Your body, your actions will are 100% based on, effortless actions are based on whatever things are directly going to your subconscious mind. So let me just explain you the power of subconscious mind. Now, in the slide, you can see there are four different pictures. One, the lady, very happy. I mean, consider you as one of the person, very happy in your life. Second is the running horse, a horse running with a full potential. So that is the second picture. The third picture is about the target, the goals that I'm talking about. And the fourth is who is controlling the horse, okay? So these are the four things which you have in your life. Or let's see how we can work upon the permutation and combination of these things. I'll tell you. You are there. That running horse with 100% potential is your own potential. That is the unlimited potential that everyone has. Goals. We'll see whether you have goals or not in your life. And the person who is taking care of your 100% potential, unlimited potential that you have in your life. So for a layman, let me tell you, for a layman, you are there, a person is there. Every person has unlimited potential. Second picture of a horse, the running horse with complete potential. Second picture, the unlimited potential you already have in your subconscious mind, let me tell you. But the third picture, if you don't have any targets in your life, if you don't have any goals in your life, the fourth picture, the other people will be able to drive your potential. You will not be driving your potential. The other person is going to drive your potential in your life. And throughout your life, you'll be working for the achievement of the goals of the other people in your life. So that is the first permutation and combination I worked out. Let's take the second permutation and combination. You are there, your unlimited potential, your horse is there, okay, with you. And you also know, you are driving your horse. You also know how to drive your potential. You know you have talent. You know everything in your life. You have all the information. You are very well aware of your unlimited potential. But if you don't have any goals or set targets in your life, what will happen? The horse will still be running at the 100% potential. You will be working with your 100% potential, but no direction. You don't know where your horse or where your potential will lead you in your life. So again, this was the second permutation and combination. The third permutation combination, let's work out. You are there, your 100% potential, unlimited potential is there with you all the time in your subconscious mind, but you don't have any goals or set targets in your life. Also, you're not aware about, you don't know how to drive your horse. You don't know how to drive your potential. You are a failure in your life. So that's the third situation. The people, those who are there, people are there, they have unlimited potential, but they don't know how to drive their unlimited potential. They don't know how to use their talent. They are not using their time effectively. They are wasting their time day and out. And even they don't have any set goals and targets in their life. So these are the failures. So we have worked out three permutation and combination. Now let me tell you the ideal situation of this particular thing, where you, the ideal situation of those 2 to 3% people, those who are able to achieve their goals in their life. So they are there, the person is there, unlimited potential is there with everybody, no doubt. Your goals are there, set targets are there. And the moment your goals are there, you have set targets in your life, you know the purpose of life, what you want to do, then automatically you are able to drive your horse, your unlimited potential as per the goals in your life. And you have a proper clear-cut direction, and whatever efforts you are putting in your life, it will lead you towards the achievement of your goal. So I think I have made myself clear that how subconscious mind has an amazing power within you. It has an unlimited potential. The only thing that is required in your life is a direction. And that direction, only you can provide that direction in your life. So that is the power of goal setting. The success you can achieve in your life through goal setting. Now also let me brief you about the key to break that wall. There is a thin wall between a conscious and subconscious mind. A thin wall. Now how to break that wall and take everything, all the information that you are getting directly to the subconscious mind. Because what happened, the information is whatever you are receiving through 5 senses, it is directly coming to your conscious mind. And the moment it is coming to your conscious mind, you are applying logic, you are doing analytical thinking based on your experience, your judgments and all, and you take the decision. And that's all. That is a very small part. Hum kehte hai, jiski soch choti hai, wo sirf conscious mind use kar raha hai, wo sirf basic analysis use kar raha hai. And let me tell you, there is nothing right and wrong in anyone's life. Because whatever information you are receiving, you are analyzing it based on your own memory, based on your past experience, your conscious mind. And different information goes to different people and they will have different analysis. They have different conclusions. They have different perspective onto that. So nothing is right and wrong. It's only how you're using your conscious mind. So don't rely on your conscious mind, because it does not guarantee you that whether you are right or wrong in your life. Everything lies within the subconscious mind. So let's find out the key to break that wall and take the information directly to the subconscious mind. Now there are 6 important keys or 6 important points that we can go through, that we can apply in our life to take the things directly to our subconscious mind, and it will help us to achieve goals in our life. So first important thing is visualization. Let's discuss it in brief, very brief. I'll just tell you in brief the things, because these are the different techniques and we can spend hours and hours on this one technique, okay? So I'll just let you know the brief about it. So the first important key to move towards the subconscious mind is visualization. Visualization is actually comprises of imagination and visuals. We all imagine things in our life, what we want, and we also imagine the good situation in our life, what exactly we want in our life. But imagination is not enough. We need to visualize those imagination. Visualize means we need to picturize it. Okay, your visuals, whatever you want in your life, your imagination, your goals in your life, just imagine by creating visuals in your mind that it needs to be very colorful, it needs to be big and large enough. You can actually see yourself into that position and just feel that you are actually in that position, and it should move like a movie. Like one by one, the instances are happening in your life and you are moving towards the achievement of the goals. So visuals needs to be guided by you only. You need to guide your visuals based on your goals and your purpose, your direction in your life. You have to give direction to your visuals, because it's a normal tendency of a mind to wander here and there the moment you are not focused. And it is very easy for the mind to wander here and there. It is only you can provide directions to your mind. And let me tell you, many people, they feel that mind ye soch raha hai to hum kya kare. So it is, mind is only an organ. The brain is only an organ, one of the organ of your body. It is like you have to decide how you have to get that organ worked on in your benefit, in your favor. So it is only an organ, let me tell you. Now let's talk about the another key, that is affirmations. Affirmations is like, start speaking positive to yourself. Again and again, if you speak to yourself the positive things, you are going to achieve many things in your life. And that when you are speaking, always speak in a present continuous form. Like if you speak, say for example, if you're very poor in your life and you want to be rich, you want a lot of money in your life, and you start creating affirmations like, I have become rich. I have become rich. Main rich ban gaya hoon ya ban gayi hoon. So your conscious mind is going to reject that, because there is no logic to it. The conscious mind can see that you are actually struggling for food day and night. You don't have money. And you are saying that you have become rich. So your conscious mind will directly reject the statement, and the statement will not go to the subconscious mind. So you can say it in a present continuous form like, I am becoming rich. I am working and I am becoming rich. And I will become rich. Yes, I am working on it. I am becoming rich. So you need to repeat this statement day and night, every now and then in your mind. Automatically, again and again, if you do the things repetitively, it will go to your subconscious mind. And the moment the things goes to the subconscious mind that you are becoming rich, you are becoming rich, your actions will be your body, your actions will be your every effort will be directed towards becoming rich. You'll be start putting a lot of efforts. Your mind will started looking for the directions and way out of earning more and more better money through a better work and all. So these are the power of affirmations. You need to speak out. And the best time to do self-affirmation is when you're going to first sleep. Just speak out these things for 20-30 times again and again within yourself, and that voice has to be very loud, clear, and very strong within that. Every part of your body is speaking that thing, what you want in your life. And also then you have to do it twice a day. And the second time it is when you wake up in the morning. You can do these affirmations for 20-30 times, and then you move out of your bed. So that is the another technique, affirmation. First was visualization. Second is affirmation. The third is doing it. Yes, very, very true that only by imagining certain things and doing affirmations, we cannot achieve our goals in our life. We need to do it. We need to take action. And I would say just do it. Don't even give a second thought to it. And the moment the things have gone to your subconscious mind, your body will start acting in a way. The body will start behaving in a way towards providing direction to you. And your body will start moving. Your actions will be there towards the achievement of your goal. So program your mind for whatever you want in your life. And do these practice again and again, again and again. The moment you keep on doing practice, you'll be achieving. Because practice is the only key. The hard work is the only key to achieve something in your life. So not only affirmations and visualizations are going to help you out. These are the six important keys I'll be discussing. And all of the keys are so important, and they have to go on simultaneously within you. Next is metaphor. Metaphor is basically to understand. Metaphor in Hindi we call it as sanket or symbols. So to understand any concept, our mind needs a lot of symbols. And with those symbols provided by you, mind can easily understand the concept. हम चीजें याद भी करते हैं तो उनको relate करते हैं किसी चीजों से and we provide symbols and clues to it and then we start retaining that information within us. So mind accepts whatever you provide it with symbols. Even without logic, the mind accepts it to provide it with symbols. So I would say the stories are the best way through which the mind can easily grasp anything without even logic. You can just imagine. The best example I can give is of a movies that you are watching. Many times it happens, you are so involved in a movie that you even feel crying and you start crying or you laugh aloud and you feel patriotic from within when you watch patriotic movie. So without any logic, your mind is accepting these things and the mind is making you crying. You know that this is only a story, this is only a movie that is going around, still that makes you cry, still that makes you laugh aloud. Still, that makes you feel patriotic for a few days. So that is, the mind has accepted everything. The things are actually directly going to the subconscious mind without any logic, without any role of conscious mind. So whatever you want to achieve in your life, if you want the things directly go to your subconscious mind and your body starts reacting towards it, apply symbols and clues and metaphor and start speaking to yourself in the form of a story. So whatever you want to learn or make others learn, relate it to your wonderful story, and that will actually strike to your emotional level and directly the things will go to your subconscious mind. You need not to apply any logic behind that. That is one of the technique. Another, the fifth one is repetition. Repetition is, yes, if you want to learn something, you want to change your habit, it is always being said that repeat that thing again and again, do this thing again and again, and automatically those repeated patterns, what you are doing, will get registered in your subconscious mind. It will get registered in your subconscious mind the more and more you do things or you repeat the things in your life. So like swimming, dancing, a musician, athletes, they practice a lot regularly. They do the things repetitively again and again. And that's why they gain that expertise into that particular thing. So if you leave your practice, then whatever neural pathways are formed in your mind, the pattern which is formed in your mind, it will directly go into the... If you leave your practice, the pattern which is following and it is going to your subconscious mind, the pattern will get break. And again, you will be back on the track of not achieving anything. So don't leave your practice. Do the things continuously, repetitively. And the last part is create the focus. Whatever we want to learn in our life, whatever we want to achieve in our life, it is very important to create focus. So if you don't have clear focus, then you may take months and years to achieve something. And the people, those who have a strong focus, it is very easy for them to achieve their goals within few days, a few months. And as compared to other people, those who lack focus, and they'll take years and years to accomplish their goals. So it is very much important to develop focus of your mind. Now, you might be saying that bolna asaan hota hai ki focus hona chahiye, but how? How to develop focus, because the mind has a tendency to move here and there every now and then. So listen carefully. Your mind has a tendency, as I said, to move here and there. Now, how to develop focus in your life? You can develop focus in your life by visualizing the benefits of your goals, by visualizing the benefits of what you are going to achieve in the near future, because mind has a tendency to move towards the benefit and away from the pain. So the moment you are more and more focusing yourself towards the benefit of what you are going to achieve in your life, automatically you will your mind will start creating focus on the things which will generate benefits for you. So whatever you want in your life, the goals, just imagine the benefits of if you would have achieved those goals in your life, what happens? Okay, so these are the six important keys I wanted to discuss to achieve how you are going to achieve your goal. So I would end by saying that when you focus on the problem, you lose the goal. But when you focus on the goal, you lose the problem. So just be focused in your life. And first of all, set clear-cut goals in your life. Pen down your goals. Write down the pathways, the directions, how you're going to achieve your goals. And that too, it needs to be smart enough, as we already discussed. And time-bound, it needs to be time-bound, one of the criteria of the SMART goal. And this is the way, step-by-step, you can follow these six keys and you'll be able to achieve your goals in your life. So thank you so much. And I feel that, yes, I have added certain value to you people. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable inputs. Whatever you have said, these are just really going to help us in our future. So I would like everyone, if anyone is having questions, then please you can ask, ma'am.
Yes, please. If anybody has any questions, please, I'm open to that.
Okay, so I hope no one is having questions, ma'am. First of all, I'm really sorry for the glitch that occurred. So, yeah.
Not an issue. That's very natural. It happens. On the online mode, it is very natural that we face technical glitch every now and then.
Yeah, ma'am, I have a question actually. So you told us about goal setting. So whatever I have understood, that goal is basically a bigger picture that we look into. So yes. My question is that is it necessary, like if I talk about objectives is basically focusing on the small parts. So objective is actually short term. So is it necessary that we can set goals directly, or we need to take baby steps for setting a goal? Like we need to form some short objectives and then we can move on to set a bigger goal.
No, I would say we can go the other way around. Bada socho to bada hoga, jaise hum kehte hai. I'll take the example of Dhirubhai Ambani. If you have seen the movie Guru, it is a pure depiction of the life of Dhirubhai Ambani. Now, Dhirubhai Ambani belongs to a very poor family. His father was just a school teacher, and he said to him that don't dare to dream because dreams will never come true. Itne bade sapne mat dekho. But he dared to dream, and he proved to the entire world by becoming the biggest industrial tycoon, business tycoon, that dreams can be achieved. So I also personally believe bada socho to bada hoga. First of all, your purpose in your life should be very clear. What exactly you want from your life? What excites you? What makes you happy in your life? So that can be your purpose in your life. And based on that purpose, you can set your goals and then your objectives in a very smart way. Let it be very specific, achievable, measurable, and time-bound things. So I would say you should go the other way. First of all, set your bigger goals. First of all, you need to dream. Sapne dekhne aasan hai aur sab dekhte hai. So just dream out. And out of those dreams, what exactly you want in your life, set your goals and then objectives with proper directions and pathway.
Okay. Ma'am, one more question I have is I have read about you. So it is basically you provide training or related to NLP. So NLP, which I have come across, is basically it provides practical ways by which you can basically change the way you think. So is it always necessary that we need an expert advice to do that, or we can do it by our own willpower?
I personally believe that, yes, the word you used, willpower, NLP has certain techniques to change your thinking pattern, okay? It has techniques to change your thinking pattern so that you live your life purposefully for happiness, okay? Now, the way you used the word willpower, it is like, I personally believe if you have a strong will to do something, so no NLP, nothing is required in your life. If you have a will, you have a proper goals, you have proper direction, and you know where you want to reach in your life. No NLP, no other techniques, artificial techniques you require in your life, because will is always more important than skill. Even if a person has a skill, but still there is a question whether he's going to apply that skill, whether he's going to work on that skill or not. But if you have a will and you don't have a skill, so it is very easy for a person who is very strongly has a will to do something, he will acquire that skill in a near future, very soon. So that will is obviously more important for anybody.
Okay. Ma'am, we have a question from Ricky Mishra. So yes, she is asking, kindly tell us what is the difference between goal, objective and target?
Goals are basically, as you also said, it's a bigger version. You have vision in your life, you have purpose in your life, then we have goals, and after goals we have objectives. That is a clear cut path that you mention, the pathway, the directions in your life, and targets are very specific. For each objective, for each goal, you can have a different target. Okay, because one by one you are going to achieve your targets along with your objectives, then only you'll be able to achieve your goals and purpose in your life.
Okay. So are there any one questions? Any questions from the audience? Okay. All right. So, ma'am, one last question is that you are like basically into human resource management.
Yes.
So, like, what exactly motivated you to take like these kind of to move into the area of human resource management? Because I am personally also like very fascinated, and the reason only I take. As a career objective also.
You are not
in my
audible.
Personal yes. life, like I have many yes. friends who seek. Yeah. Hello, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes. You're audible now.
Yeah. So I was saying that in my personal life also, if I talk about, many of my close friends, sometimes they come and seek advice. So this is a kind of I feel employee grievance handling kind of situation. So I like it. And what things you faced in, or what actually motivated you to take it?
Human resource management, actually, it is very close to my heart. The reason is I love interacting with people. I'm very empathetic. There is a difference between being sympathetic and empathetic. I'll tell you difference in a very simple way. Sympathy is only through words, but empathy is through actions.
Actions, yeah.
Yes. So I'm very empathetic, and so many years, I'm in the after my college life and all, I realized that yes, I have a bent towards interacting with people. I can understand them so well, and I am a very good counselor, and I can very well counsel. And the moment I end up being in a teaching profession after my corporate job. So there I interacted with many students every now and then, new batches of students, and how well I can understand the psyche of a student. And over a period of time, I realized that yes, I can understand people so well, and I can very well narrate and give lectures to them, and I counsel them. And it is like over a period of time, I analyzed that yes, this is the bent I have towards, and I would love to deliberate more and more of my knowledge to the benefit of the mankind. So that's why I shifted into this.
Okay. All right, ma'am. Thank you so much for this valuable session. So I would like Poonam to go for the vote of thanks. Thank you so much, ma'am. We learned
thank
a lot
you so
from
much.
You.
It's my privilege to deal with you. I mean, to interact with you people. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much once again, ma'am, for this wonderful knowledge. We will make sure that we will not be a stock clerk and will follow SMART goals and pen down our goals by giving them directions and we'll come up with the all myths. And thank you so much again on the behalf of the whole team of Air Cruise Aviation. Thank you, ma'am.
Thanks a lot. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ron.
Thank you.